Hey there, myself Harkishma Reddy. Welcome to our YouTube channel HKR Knowledge. Today I am going to teach you some basics of English. So, are you eagerly waiting to know the history of English? If you say yes, let me tell you the history of English. History of English. English was derived from Germanic languages such as Spanish, Danish, Swedish, etc. And also, the most of the part of English had derived from the language Greek. So, here we know the English origins. But these are not the exact origins of English. So, still there is no clarity on origin of English. It's become question mark. So, English had used in 5th century. In 5th century, English had used it for first time to communicate with each other. Later, it spread all over the world. So, from this, did you got any point? Did you observe any point? Yes, you have observed one point that English had mostly used it by Germany, Germanian people or Germanic people. So, this was the history of English. So, let's move on to the next topic. Now, let us see the formation of script in English. Formation of script in English. It includes of so many steps. So, at first, we have alphabets. How many alphabets are there in English? We have 26 alphabets. Again, these 26 alphabets are divided into two groups. One is ovals and second is consonants. So, here, ovals are the letters which produces sound and gives support to consonants. So here we can see ovals and consonants. So next, ovals includes of A, E, I, O, U. Ovals includes of what letters? Ovals includes of A, E, I, O, U. And next, when we come to consonants, consonant includes of B, C, B, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Y, Z. So these are consonants. So these are two types of letters in alphabets. So here we have mainly to concentrate on ovals, because ovals give sound to any word. So now in second step, when we join some letters, a word is formed. A word is formed with some letters. For example, here we can see A-P-P-L-E, apple. In this, A and E are vowels which gives sound, and remaining letters which are P-P-L are the consonants. So here we can keenly observe that vowels produces sound and consonants cannot be pronounced without the support of vowels. For example, if we sound PPL, we can't pronounce it, we can't pronounce that without oral support. So, let's move on together. So, here we can see ovals and consonants can form words. So, next, when some words are combined together, a sentence is formed. So, further we have example. I brushes daily, or I brush my teeth daily. We have I brush my teeth daily. So here we can observe that there are some words. So here some words forms a sentence. So later, when the some sentences are used, when some sentences are combined together, a para is formed. So here you can see this is a para. So, it comprises of some sentences. Later, when we join this para and this para, like that so many paras, when we have so many paragraphs, which is known as paragraphs, the short form of paragraphs is known as para. When we combine these paragraphs, an essay is formed. An essay. Okay, essay is formed. So, this is the formation of script in English language. In next video, I will teach you parts of speech which will be very useful to speak English in fluent way. So So this is today's video. If you have any queries related to today's video, you may leave them in the comment section of this video. Thank you for watching. I will meet you in next video. Until then, take care. Bye bye.